क्रिकेट प्रेडिक्टर पावर्ड बाय 1x बैट में आपका स्वागत है। मैच आगे बढ़ रहे हैं T20 मेंस वर्ल्ड कप 2024 के और हम पहुंच चुके हैं सुपर 8 टीम के मैचेस पे। आज का मैच है इंग्लैंड वर्सेस साउथ अफ्रीका का, जो है 45th मैच आज का। डैरन सैमी नेशनल क्रिकेट स्टेडियम में ये मैच होने वाला है और इस मैच पे पूरी चर्चा करने के लिए आज हमारे शो पे दोनों गेस्ट यहाँ मौजूद हैं। डेविड, मैं उनको बुलाना चाहूंगी, नोएल डेविड हमारे साथ मौजूद है, फॉर्मर इंटरनेशनल क्रिकेटर। आपका स्वागत है आज के प्रोग्राम में नोएल।
थैंक यू दामिनी, थैंक यू वेरी मच,
यू वेलकम। अगले प्रोग्राम में बुलाना चाहती हूँ मैं हमारे दूसरे गेस्ट, वो है तन्मय मिश्रा, फॉर्मर केन्या इंटरनेशनल क्रिकेटर, आज हमारे साथ वो भी जुड़े हैं। तन्मय, आपका स्वागत है। तन्मय,
हाय दामिनी, हाउ आर यू? गुड आफ्टरनून टू यू एंड ऑल योर व्यूअर्स। हेलो डेविड भाई।
हाय तन्मय, हाउ आर यू?
गुड गुड।
तन्मय, आई एम आल्सो डूइंग गुड। So, हम लोग पहुंच चुके हैं 45th मैच में and it's between like England and South Africa. What do you think about the match today? Let's start with it and then about the pitch and the stadium. So, Noel, what do you think about today's match? It's group 2 match today between England and South Africa. What do you think about it?
Yeah, see, both have won their first games and both are sitting pretty on top. But I feel this game is going to be a very crucial game for both of them because top team in England versus a well-known team which can give you a surprise all the time, you know. And I think South Africa, I was watching the game 2 days back where South Africa was playing the US, I guess that I think the team batted really well, you know, to the expectation what we thought, you know, when they were doing, were playing the league phase. Where they were only getting 110 or 120 and winning close encounters against, you know, Nepal and all. But they surprised me with the batting. They batted as like champions. You know, Carlson, Makram came back into form with his 47. I think they are getting there. But we have to watch how they play the England because they are the last time champions. You know, they are T20 format players. Because they play a lot of T20 matches back at home. And I feel that England will be on the upper hand against South Africa because they have a good bowling side also. So we have to keenly watch because this wicket, this ground is a bit, nice and small, St. Lucia's, where I remember me when I played my second game there against the West Indies. So I think it's going to be an interesting game.
Thank you, Noel. तन्मय, यहाँ की पिच के बारे में बात कर लें, स्टेडियम की कैसी पिच है यहाँ पर, किस तरीके की प्रॉब्लम हो सकती है या किस तरीके के बेनिफिट्स हो सकते हैं टीम को आज इस पिच पे यहाँ पर?
जी देखिए, पहले जब जहां तक हमने अभी देखा है 200 रन बने भी हैं, 180 चेस भी हुआ है इस विकेट पे। वेस्ट इंडीज में ये सबसे बेहतरीन बैटिंग विकेटों में से है। बट यहाँ आपको एक चीज दामिनी जी देखना पड़ेगा कि यहाँ 3-4 मैचेस ऑलरेडी हो गए हैं। अब क्या होता है कि आप जब बार बार सेम विकेट इस्तेमाल करोगे तो कहीं ना कहीं थोड़ा स्लो होती जाएगी। दैट बीइंग सेड, इट ऑल डिपेंड्स कि ग्राउंड स्टाफ कितनी जल्दी अच्छा विकेट प्रिपेयर कर सकता है, क्योंकि 4 मैच ऑलरेडी हो चुके हैं। हमने ये देखा भी है आईपीएल में, जब शुरुआत में आईपीएल में मैचेस होते हैं तो बड़े लंबे रन बनते हैं, बट जैसे जैसे टूर्नामेंट आगे जाता है विकेट्स आर वॉन आउट। सो आई एम अ बिट एज बैटिंग पैराडाइज दिस विकेट हैज बीन, इट हैज बीन गुड फॉर चेसिंग, इट हैज बीन गुड फॉर पोस्टिंग टोटल्स। Somewhere down the line, I know the wickets do get worn out. So you have to be mindful of that. And the people that are the people and the squad, dono ki agar squad dekhe, jo jada adaptability rakhegi us din pe, that will come out because wickets now will start slowly getting slower. To slower bowlers bhi aayenge khelne mein, medium pacers jo cutters dalte hain, wo bhi aayenge. Mujhe abhi bhi lagta hai super eights mein ki kahin na kahin ye batting wickets hoengi hi, but अब ये माइंडफुल होंगे इंग्लैंड और साउथ अफ्रीका दोनों कि विकेटें स्लो होंगी, तो उस हिसाब से इनकी स्क्वाड भी बदलेगी, तो विकेट अब ज्यादा महत्वपूर्ण रहेगा और उस हिसाब से जैसे स्क्वाड्स जो 11 रहेंगे इनके, वो चेंजेस भी लाने पड़ेंगे। जैसे इन्होंने तबरेज शमसी लाया है एंड ही इज बीन वंडरफुल, बट एक और चीज देखोगे कि तो इंग्लैंड जिस हिसाब से चेस कर रही है जब से ये सुपर एट्स में आई है, इन्होंने जो वेस्ट इंडीज के सामने भी जिस हिसाब से बैटिंग की है, तो कहीं ना कहीं इट ऑल डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हाट द विकेट ब्रिंग्स एंड द विकेट नाउ विल बिकम अ सेंटर स्टेज गोइंग फॉरवर्ड।
राइट तन्मय, जब आपने मेंशन कर ही दिया, यस नोल प्लीज।
if I had to Tanmay, you know, grounds in West Indies are not quite big, where they can make a lot of strips of wicket there. So you understand what I'm saying? Where they can have 7 to 8 strips of wicket. There are only few there, maybe 2 or 3 strips. So as Tanmay rightly said, you know, wickets are being used over and used over, where, you know, ball will tend to keep a bit slow and even low. There will be not much bounce because of the ground facility, which are small. They can't have too many wickets, so where they can prepare new wickets all the time. So that is only the problem because of the grounds.
जी नोल, आपको क्या लगता है आज कौन से प्लेयर हो सकते हैं साउथ अफ्रीका के जो कोई डिफरेंस क्रिएट कर सकते हैं आज के मैच में, जिनके होने से शायद प्रॉब्लम हो दूसरी टीम को?
देखिए, उनके पास हर कोई प्लेयर है, यू नो, एक शानदार खिलाड़ी है. यू नेम देम, यू नो, सी वी ऑल एक्सपेक्ट, वी नेवर थॉट, यू नो, विद द फॉर्म व्हाट मकरम इज, बट ही केम गुड द अदर डे. यू नो, हिज 47 वाज वाइटल रन्स, बिकॉज़ इफ ही हैडन स्कोर्ड देन आई थिंक the South Africa would have been in doldrums, because Miller failed. Miller got out on the first ball, quarter ball, you know, he failed. Carlson, you know, he got that quick fire 48 or something. See, it is everyone who can contribute. De Kock, you see, he came back into form. So each and everyone there are brilliant. And I think even the bowling, you know, with Rabada, not there, everyone are brilliant. So I can't name one player, but what I can say, who can be you know, one guy who can always change the face of the game, I can say if David Miller is there, I think he can change it.
Right. Tanmay, agar main dusri team ki taraf aaun, England mein kaun se players aapko lagta hai jin pe aaj focus rahega?
देखिए, डिफेंडिंग चैंपियंस हैं, और जहां तक डेविड भाई ने कहा है कि इस फॉर्मेट में आप एक इंडिविजुअल, अगर क्रिस गेल होते तो उनका नाम ले सकते थे, बट वो एक अलग ही इंडिविजुअल है. बट यहाँ जैसे डेविड भाई ने कहा कि एक टीम का पूरा कंट्रीब्यूशन रहता है इस फॉर्मेट में. बट अगर हम बात करें इंग्लैंड की, तो उनकी जो बैटिंग है, बैटिंग यूनिट की बात करूंगा, इंडिविजुअली नहीं, जो बैटिंग यूनिट है बड़ी धमाकेदार है. वर्सिटिलिटी भी है उनमें. हमने पहले देखा था कि मोइन अली थोड़ा नीचे आ रहे थे, अब उन्होंने पिछले गेम में नंबर 3 पे बैटिंग किया, तो वो सॉर्ट ऑफ शिफ्ट गियर्स भी है इनमें, कि उनके पास ऐसे बैट्समैन भी हैं कि जो पावर प्ले, फिल सॉल्ट, और जहां तक हमने देखा है कि जिस हिसाब से उन्होंने बैटिंग की है और जॉस बटलर के साथ, अगर उनका क्लिक नहीं हुआ तो वो एक बैटर भेज देते हैं. एक वर्सिटिलिटी है इनके बैटिंग यूनिट में, तो ये उनका सबसे बड़ा स्ट्रेंथ है, विच आई बिलीव दैट इट्स देयर एबिलिटी टू अडैप्ट एंड रिएक्ट. इट्स नॉट अ सेट batting lineup. Apart from the openers, they can send anyone. That unpredictability in this format can be dangerous for the oppositions, because they've got a couple of guys who can just go and absolutely take the bull by its horn. And we saw it the other day, they chased 180 runs comfortably. Johnny Bairstow's got a bit of form now. Phil Salt's been brilliant. The fact that they tried Moeen Ali, it also goes to show that the sort of depth they have down there. They haven't even used Curran right now. And Livingston hasn't even had a hit. Harry Brook has come good. So, as a batting unit, they are very strong. And if you're tactically speaking, I would want South Africa to chase. Because if you give England to chase, because of the depth in their batting, they can really cause you trouble. This is still a good wicket to bat on, don't get me wrong. But, you know, somewhere down the line, over the years, the one thing that T20 cricket has brought into this game a lot is, it has brought batsmen's confidence to another level. They can chase any total down. So I'd be wary of that from a South African point of view. So that is something that England's strength is. It's their batting ability to adapt and react and maybe make sure that they have enough players that can shuffle around the top order. Just not right, one batter.
Right, Tanmay. Noel, मैं आपके पास अगर आऊँ, head-to-head players के बारे में बात करते हैं. मैं आपको दो नाम दूंगी और उनके बारे में आप कुछ बताइएगा. पहला नाम है जॉस बटलर वर्सेस कगिसो करबाडा. इन दोनों के बारे में आपको क्या कहना है? दोनों अलग-अलग टीम हेड टू हेड कई बार आ चुके हैं एक दूसरे के सामने.
इफ यू सी जॉनी ब्रेस्टो, यू आर टॉकिंग ऑफ जॉस बटलर और जॉनी ब्रेस्टो?
जॉस बटलर
यू नो, अ डायनामिक ओपनर. यू नो, वी हैव सीन हिम न्यूमरस टाइम वेयर ही गेट्स गोइंग ड्यूरिंग द पावर प्ले. इज अ गुड स्ट्राइकर एंड is good of the medium fast bowlers. Spinners, yes, is a bit dicey sometimes, but fast bowlers here. And if you talk about Rabada, what a bowler. We saw him the other day. He changed the care of this thing of the game, you know. When he came, he got the wickets against the US. You know, he bowled a very good line and length. He's really quick, really quick. And I feel that he can be a dangerous guy for the English people.
Right, Noel. Tan mein Johnny Brin, Bairstow aur Tabrez ke bare mein agar aap kya kehna chahenge dono ke?
I think that's a very good matchup that you brought up, because Tabrez, the way he's bowling, he comes in the middle overs where Johnny Bairstow is looking to attack. I think in this scenario, the fact that the wickets will be slightly, good for batting, but even slightly, there will be something for the spinners. So it'll be good to see with the fact that both players, Johnny Bairstow's got a bit of form and he's hitting the ball well, but Tabrez Samsi also has been taking regular wickets. Yes, he went for a few runs, but overall, when you look at it, they're both coming into this contest with a lot of confidence. I would like slightly lean towards Johnny Bairstow because, the thing is, the one thing IPL has taught is a lot of foreign batsmen who come and play the IPL, they have become better at playing spin. Or Johnny Bairstow's timing and strength is second to none. So it'll be an interesting contest, but if I have to speak, I think I'd slightly be leaning towards Johnny Bairstow in this one.
Right. Noel, aapke paas aata hai wapas. Henrich ya fir Adil Rashid versus Adil Rashid?
Well, we have, Adil has just in a recent time, he's grown up, he's developed his skills a lot. I've been watching his reels all the time, where he goes into practice, and gets into his bowling something new all the time. I think he's very skillful. He has developed a lot of techniques of to bowl. He's got a new ball which comes out of hand, and it's not like the flipper type, but he pushes where the ball doesn't bounce much, but he just skips through and comes. I think that one ball he has developed very well, and it's become a bit dangerous because a lot of LBW chances. Andrich has always been I think he's the fastest bowler, I think, if I'm not mistaken. Tanmay, if you correct me.
Right? What's that? I'm sorry. Your voice is breaking.
She's talking the Nodridge, okay? The fast bowler of the South African, if I'm not mistaken. Right?
Nokia.
Is it Nokia you're talking
Henrik
about?
Klassen. Henrik Klassen you're talking about. Henrik Klassen and Adil Rashid, right?
Yes.
Oh,
batsman, right. Henrik Klassen.
And Henrik, if I take Henrik, I'm a great admirer of him, because the way I've been watching him during the Sunrisers, a good wicket keeper, brilliant keeper also, and I think he comes into the side as a very dangerous batsman in the form of T20. He can turn around the game at his will. If you see yesterday, the other day's match, the way he's played, sensibly plays, at the same time he attacks. So I think he's a very dangerous guy in that middle order, where he comes at number four or five of four. Sometimes he comes four and or five. He's very dangerous there.
Just to echo David Sir's point, in the last two seasons or two and a half, three seasons in World T20 cricket, I don't think so there's been a better batsman who comes at number four, five and bats. In fact, in the world right now, Henrik Klassen by a length is the best batsman currently going around. And it's his ability to play spin that has really taken the eyes. It has caught us off guard. Normally when we talk about spin, we talk about subcontinent players. Guys like Sangakkara, Mahila Jayawardene, Virat Kohli, just subcontinent batters. But this is one guy who's come, and his ability to hit the ball while standing, that has really taken a step back. No one does that. Normally you have to use your feet for the spinners. You've got to get down right on close to the ball. But the fact that this guy has this ability to stay so steady and generate power while standing, he's really someone. This is exactly why I want to echo David Sir's point that if South Africa chases, I think they'll be in the game.
Yes, Tanmay.
He's quite tall, He's got a good reach.
Yeah.
Yes, Tanmay and Noel, thank you for sharing all the insights on today's match. It was a great discussion with you both. And you have already mentioned a lot of strengths in different players from both the teams. Either it's England, either it's South Africa. So let's see who's going to win today. Super 8 shuru ho chuka hai, Group 2 ka match hai aaj. Thank you very much for being a part of this program and sharing all the insights on the match. Thank you very much. Cricket Predictor powered by 1xBat. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.